Hi YouTube, especially to all Star Wars fans, this is Toto8776 once again bringing you another toy haul video. And first of all, I would like to apologize to all my viewers, subscribers and my super friends for deleting my previous video about Star Wars because it didn't turn out the way I wanted it to be. But good news, I'm reloading this and made a little bit of changes, so I hope you enjoy this video and thank you for supporting it again. So without further delay, let's start with this Bluray disc set. Yep, as you can see here, it's Star Wars the complete saga. Bluray disc set, it includes 9 discs and also includes 6 movies, over 40 hours of special features with 90 minutes of Star Wars spoofs. Yep, let's take a look of what's inside this Bluray disc. As you can see, it looks like a book. There you are, look at the artwork, very cool. Let's open it. So this is the first page. Of course, first is the Phantom Menace. You can see here Darth Maul. Very cool artwork, it's a nice painting. Next, Attack of the Clones. As you can see here, Padme Amidala and Anakin Skywalker. This is when Anakin have dreamt about or foreseen about her mother being captive of the Sand People, so he's worried and wanted to rescue his mother. Next, Revenge of the Sith. Look at the artwork, very cool and very dark. See, so look, he's a little bit scary here with the yellow eyes. Yep, and this is where he had a duel with his Master Jedi Obi-Wan Kenobi in the planet of Mustafar. Let's proceed. A New Hope or Episode 4. Try to look at this picture. From my camera, it looks like a photo, but actually it's a painting. Yep, look. Take a closer look. It's just a painting, but very nicely painted. Nice artwork. This is how they look like when they were young. Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher, and Harrison Ford, of course. Next, The Empire Strikes Back, of course, with Yoda. And last but not the least, Return of the Jedi. As you can see here, Luke Skywalker having a duel fight with his father, Darth Vader, aka Anakin Skywalker. They're fighting in front of the Emperor, Emperor Palpatine, or Darth Sidious. Okay, next, aside from the 6 movies, it includes 3 bonus discs. And here's the artwork of the first disc. As you can see here, Boba Fett riding this reptilian avian like creature, where Obi-Wan Kenobi rode on this creature in Revenge of the Sith. Next, the bonus disc 2, and this artwork is with Han Solo together with the Ewoks. Very cool. Followed by the bonus disc number 3. This is a concept artwork where, as you can see here, there's C-3PO and R2-D2 with this Imperial, you know, I'm not so sure, it looks like a concept AT-AT, but it didn't turn out this way. And last but not the least, as you can see here, this is an artwork of all the Star Wars characters in one artwork. Actually, it's a huge artwork where they have included all the Star Wars characters, but they just featured all the main characters here. Like for example, Anakin Skywalker when he was an adult and when he was still young. Mace Windu, Yoda, who else? Darth Vader of course, and Qui-Gon Jinn there. And Obi-Wan Kenobi when he was young, when he turned old. Boba Fett and young Boba Fett. So that's it folks. This is how the Blu-ray disc set looks like. So if you're interested, you can buy them at your favorite store like Walmart, Target. And I think they're also selling this at Toys R Us. But I ordered this online because it's cheaper and it's free shipping that time. But now, you know, but by the way, at Walmart, it's also free shipping, but you have to pick it up on your local Walmart. So that's the Star Wars The Complete Saga Blu-ray disc. Let's proceed to the action figures. First, we have Han Solo in best fit outfit. Yep, look at this. Look at the details they made on the face and the body sculpt. It's very proportioned. Look at this. The face, it looks closely looks like the real one. Very nice. Very cool. That's why I like the vintage collection, because it's the definitive version of all the Star Wars figures. This is how he looks like before. Can you see how much improvement they have made? And he is a VC50. So that is Han Solo. Next, Barry Sophie, Jedi Padawan of Luminara Unduli. As you can see from afar, it looks like a real face of a woman. But when you get closer, yeah, still looks like a real face, but you know, well sculpted, very well molded, and the tattoos there, the details of the face, the eyes, the lips, the cheeks, the chin, very proportioned, and of course the body, and they use cloth for the lower garment so that you can pose her lower extremities the way you want it to be. And this is the artwork. This is where at Geonosis, where she fought together with the other Jedis to fight against the Separatists. This is how she looks like from 2002 to 2004. Look at that. I think this is not articulated. It's just like a statue. So that's Barry Sophie. Oops. Next, we have Rebel Fleet Trooper. As you can see here, another improvement made by Hasbro and Kenner. This is how it looks like way back in 1995. It's not proportioned. The shoulder is too broad, and there's less articulation. Unlike the present figure right now, it has a lot of articulations. There's knee articulation and there's ankle articulation, but I don't like the articulation on the hips. This kind of articulation only has the ability to move it forward and backward, but not side to side, so it restricts the movement of the hip. But nonetheless, this is a very cool figure because it has a great details on it, and the body is well proportioned and very much alike with of the person in the picture. So that is Rebel Fleet Trooper. Next, it's Bomb Vimdin, Cantina Patron, one of the aliens that you, if you can remember, you've seen in New Hope. As you can see here, he has this rhino type of horn on his head. And if you compare this face with the face here in the figure, is almost closely perfect. Very well molded. Yep, the details is very good. And also the details on the vest, look at that. Very cool and very nice. From head down to his feet, all, you know, have high details. You can't imagine for a 3¾-inch figure, they're going to put, you know, so much detail on it. So that's Bomb Vemdin. Next, ARC Trooper Commander. Yep, those Star Wars fans, they are really looking for this or hunting for these figures, because who wouldn't love this figure? Look at him. He looks so badass. Look at that. You can remove the helmet and reveal his face. Well, most of you guys know already what his face is, and you can replace with this helmet. Look at that. And his VC-54. Yep. As you can see, all of them are on VC-50, so it's in chronological order. Next, given to me by Mr. Sensitivity, Logray, the Ewok Medicine Man. Yep. So if you haven't seen this guy, check my previous videos, and I have featured this Ewok there. And look at the previous Logray from 1983. Look at that. Look at the evolution. Very nicely done now. So here's VC-55. Okay. So these are Wave 7 of the Vintage Collection. So I hope you guys already have this. Actually, it's been released a few months ago, but you know, Star Wars are releasing them in limited, you know, quantities. So I hope for you guys already have them. If not, you can check your local Target, Walmart, Toys R Us, or you can buy them online too. So this is Star Wars 2011 Wave 7 of the Vintage Collection. Watch out for my Star Wars The Clone Wars video coming up next. So guys, enjoy collecting, keep collecting, and thank you for watching. See ya!